Hello there, Seraphim17 once again. This is my Uncharted 3 Brutal Difficulty video walkthrough. This is Chapter 12, it's Abducted, and this is the part that you all came to see. Because this is where brutal starts becoming brutal, and you either respond in kind, or you'll never get past it. So at the beginning, you have a massive Arkham Asylum-esque brawl against all these... Are they pirates, these people? I've never really understood this part of the game. You know, you get captured by a pirate guy who doesn't like you and potentially has some like past history with you, and then you fight in a bunch of ships in a shipyard and ship graveyards and stuff, and then you go on a big boat and the pirate's there and you fight more pirates, and then it's all forgotten afterwards. It's been a while since I watched the story on Uncharted 3, so I'm assuming it makes more sense in the game's context, but I always found it silly. But I love this level. I do. I think this is one of the better levels in the game because it's just... It's brutal. And that's what I came for, you know. I came to this difficulty for a very specific reason. I wanted to get destroyed, and I didn't get destroyed in the way I was expecting. I got killed a lot, don't get me wrong. If you're coming to this difficulty with illusions, you're not going to die. You're either, you know, the luckiest man alive, or you're just... I don't know, you're a robot or something, because I don't know how you wouldn't die on something so brutal as this. Not in particular this. This fight right now is actually really easy, because nobody fights you until you're coming out of an animation. So everybody stands and waits the turn like we're in some Chuck Norris TV show, so that's handy. But here comes the black pirate heavy guy. You'll notice his outfit is the same outfit on the super heavy dude who turns up on the boat. Because when you throw a grenade and you knock the plates off him, he looks kind of like this guy. And I had a subscriber who was telling me that he had a nightmare on that particular fight. So I'm really excited to share video 14 with him so he can see how I handle it. Because I managed to get it on, like, I think it was the first or second attempt. And the only reason I died on the first attempt is because I tried to beat him up. Don't try and beat up the massive heavy guys. It doesn't work. They have this auto counter, and they'll kick you away, and then they'll do this really cheeky shot that instantly murders you. And I tried on a different run a few times to see if I could beat it, and there's just no beating it. Even if you mash triangle when you know it's coming, you cannot beat their counter. It's hilarious. So instead, you want to just make sure that you trigger the cutscene, make sure that you've got a checkpoint, and make sure you've got a grenade. If you've got a grenade, you can strip his armor off, and then you can just shoot him in the face and he's dead. It's pretty simple stuff. And then you just kill his friends, and I've got a really good spot for it. So do not fear, folks, if you're having issues there. I've got a really, really great, quick strategy for that one. But we're not quite there yet. This is Abducted. We are going to do some platforming. And I just want to reiterate here, guys, be careful with the platforming, because it's great, but it has holes in it. And those holes were filled on Uncharted 4, but they're not here. So certain scenarios you can fall and die and lose progress and things off of really silly stuff, where Drake won't lean towards the thing you want him to lean towards. And when he jumps, he doesn't grab things. And it's the stuff that Uncharted has always had. Some people come across it, some people don't. I always come across it because I'm just crappy at platforming, apparently. Even though I was brought up on the N64 where platforming was king, I just haven't quite grasped the full concept of it, it would seem. But this next fight is probably the hardest fight in the game, in my opinion. And I say this because it's bullshit. Fancy that. For one reason, the game gives you a checkpoint halfway through which will trap you in a corner of its design. You do not choose this. It chooses for you, and I hate that. And I hate it for one specific reason. You can stealth this room coming up. You can stealth all of them, all the way up until the rocket launcher guys spawn. But you'll never get the opportunity to do it if you fuck up and it checkpoints you into a scenario you don't want. And that's exactly what you're going to see, guys. I had a great strategy for stealthing everybody, but I think the last guy... And I couldn't share it with you because I got caught on the recording run and it checkpointed me in a place I'd never been with everybody alert, and it goes to hell in a handbasket, and I had to deal with it. And it's my fault because I fucked up, but the game shouldn't do that. It should give me the choice to go back, and it doesn't. And I didn't want to do that entire fight at the beginning to reset the spawn. Because what's the point, you know? That it shouldn't force me to do that, and I got really, really pissed. And then I found a strategy that I've used before, but It just seemed to be really apt, because if they're going to fuck with me, I'm going to show you a spot where they can't fuck with you. But you need bullets, so save as much pistol ammo as you can, guys, because it's going to be very important in round two. But at the beginning, two dudes are going to talk. Dude on the left's going to come towards us, we're going to drown his ass. Dude on the right's going to walk over there, we're going to drown his ass afterwards. So wait for this guy, as soon as he pivots, grab him. Do not mash grab, or you'll do that funny empty grab thing and they'll see it and shoot you. This next dude has a tendency to see you every so often just because his myopia fades and he gets really good 20/20 vision. So I like to grab on that second bar, not the top bar, you dickhead, stop doing stupid things. Second bar, no, top bar, dickhead, second bar, bell end, oh, never mind. Grab him, chuck him down. You can get seen doing what I did, but he wouldn't grab the thing I wanted because he's a moron and the controls are annoying as hell. So now he's down, I'm going to go for the tower, dude. So swim over here, go underwater if you don't have cover. It's the best way of avoiding being spotted. And just know that you've triggered a guy on your right, and he's going to be patrolling, so you want to be careful of him. Because if he sees you, all of this is for naught. But I don't like the stealth here, because if you go for the two guys on the right boat, the guy on the turret sees you, and he sees you regardless of what you do, because he's bullshit. There's like a tripwire that you can trip, and it's not fair. And I don't like the guys on the left of this boat, because there's two of them, and you can't perfectly get rid of both of them. The best way I've found to do those guys on the left is shoot one in the head, and immediately mash grab to drown the other guy. And that seems to be the quickest way of doing them, but I can't show you any of this, of course, because I cock up. But I'm waiting for the guy on the right to reset and start his path again. I didn't need to do this, because I had enough time, but I'm being very cautious because it's really easy to get spotted here, and the gunfight that happens when you get spotted is not easy, guys. It's very difficult. People flank you, there's tons of people, they've got grenades, they've got really good shots, it's rough. So I shimmy to the left and I'm going to pull this guy off the roof. I pull him off the roof on this angle so nobody can see him from any other vantage, and then I'm going to get his magnum. I'm going to get his Dirty Harold, his magnum force. And then with this, we're going to proceed now to do the next dude, which is probably going to be go over towards those cargo crates. Because what I did next is I spawned those two dudes in the turret guy, and then from there, I separated the two dudes to take them out, and then I tried to flank around, I think, to the right of the turret guy, and he saw me. It was very frustrating. There's a rocket launcher if you need it. Not sure that you will. There's a couple of heavies, but if you've got two grenades, and you should have two grenades at this point, save them for the two heavies, because they're both going to stack up exactly where we need them to be, and we're gonna have some fun. So here is the mandatory spawn, right? Two guys come directly towards you, one guy stands on the blue container, one guy moves to his left and jumps across to that other boat. Behind them is the dude on the turret. If you go to the left of here and you climb up the hull of the ship that's near the mast that leads to the next section with the two dudes, you can pull those two dudes over the edge of the ship and they don't notice it, which is great. But if you climb up behind them, regardless of what happens next, you will trip an invisible wire and everybody knows where you are. And that, to me, is disgusting design, because it's completely unavoidable. And I tried maybe 20 times to get into cover without that turret seeing me. There was no physical way he could see me. You couldn't see me. Like, it doesn't make sense. It doesn't compute to me. And this is where the mistake's going to happen. I'm going to go for the dude in blue, and the turret guy's going to see me, I think. Because I wanted to pull him into the water and then go for his friend on the left and then go for the guy on the far left, or maybe the two dudes on the boat. I think that's the pattern I had. Two dudes on the boat, then the guy on the left, then the turret guy. Oh, maybe not. Suffice to say, this is not going to last, guys, because I did it wrong. I'm not too sure what I'm doing, actually. Well, I guess we get to see me go on a little swimming adventure, which is always fun. Oh, I'm going to go for the two guys. I bailed on it. That's what it was. So, with the looks of this, I didn't have confidence in that pattern. So I'm going to come and kill these guys. And I'm going to start the fight. I think that's exactly what's going to happen, you know. I don't know why. I could have gone for the guy in the blue container. And I reckon it might have worked if I'd have timed it. I should really go back to this sequencing and get that stealth run and show you it. But it pisses me off that I can't pick the fight. You know, I've already moved on, emotionally. But these two guys, watch this. I'm going to shoot one of them in the face, or on the body, because it's a magnum, and then I'm going to grab his pal. It's wonderful. Do it, Chris. Do it. Do it. Do it. What am I doing? I don't know. Oh, here we go. Boom. Dead. And then the fight begins. So right now, everybody knows where you are, and they're all going to be coming. They're going to be flanking onto that boat. They're going to be climbing on the top of that boat. They're going to be doing bad things. So pick up the majestic 74U, and then try and get the Rafika pistol if you can, because it's a fantastic gun. He's throwing a grenade, so stop that. And then there's going to be the dude on the turret. The dude on the turret is the least threatening person in the room. Doesn't make sense, does it? But it's true. Watch this. If you go between cover and you mash triangle, you'll either pick up a weapon or pick up a grenade. So if you want to pick that grenade up without going out of cover, that's what you want to do. The cover in this game is okay, but there are times when he will not go into cover, and sometimes he comes out of cover because you're trying to get in cover too much. It's nowhere near as sticky as Uncharted 1, but I still don't like it. And it's on the convoy, the caravan. The caravan level for cover is the most annoying thing in the game, because there were moments when all I wanted him to do was get into cover and he wouldn't do it. Like, the, I don't know why, just really, really baffling. But I'm thinning out numbers here. This doesn't really matter, because when I die, all of my work right now is going to be removed. I'm going to get flanked from the left, so there's the transition. Right here, it starts me. You notice how I picked up a grenade and I picked up the 74U? I should have picked up potentially the pistol, but getting to the spot I'm about to show you is the hardest part. If you can get to this spot, you'll be good. If you run out of ammo, that's when things get dangerous. But the trick here is, when you move to a certain position on this handhold, you cannot be shot. It's a particular spot, and you'll be fighting the game, because Nathan likes to have these fancy animations where he's swapping arms and stuff, and it fights you, but you can still shoot. So you want to move until he stops doing it, and then you are invincible here. Nothing can touch you. The grenades will never hit you. They've never hit me. I've never needed to throw any of them back, and nobody can shoot you. So pick your shots, be as accurate as possible, and hopefully you've got more than 20 bullets, because I didn't. And I'm going to have to leave this spot to get ammo, and that's the most dangerous part of the strategy. So if you have ammo, you'll be fine. But just pick your headshots, clear the numbers. And I've got one shot now, so this is bad. Ammunition's directly in front of me, where you can see that glistening shotgun, or AK, or whatever it is, next to the grenade. There is a pistol on that side, but getting the pistol and getting into this cover again is very difficult, because in two bullets you will die. So I'm about at the point where I've realised I'm going to have to do something very reckless and very dangerous. So here's me changing positions a little bit to try and shoot the sniper, but it doesn't work because I can't see. If you angle yourself correctly, you can shoot those people, but it's very particular, because when you aim to the left, Nathan wants to do an animation that the wall will not let him do. So bear that in mind. There was my final shot, and this is where the tense moment begins. So all you have to do, feasibly, if you don't have ammo, is to drop into the water, swim towards those yellow steps, grab on that side, pick up that pistol, and get back where we are. You'll notice, sniper guy's not a threat. He takes a while to shoot. Guy on top of there is the big threat, because he will kill me in two bullets very quickly. Guy on the right isn't any concern, because the turret's just a pussy. I'm going to wait for him to reload, and I'm probably going to drop. He's moved. Oh, he dropped a grenade. Wonderful, that's my opening. Do it. And there it is. He drops a grenade. He doesn't die, though, because these people are resilient. I got really lucky there on the damage. I don't know why that didn't do full damage, but that was really lenient. So now, all I want is the gun. Oh, there you go. There's that brutal damage. Pick up the gun, goddammit. Pick up the gun. I don't want to pick it up, mister. You'll shoot me.
Pick it up.
And you see? How easy did that look? It looked easy, didn't it? Well, it's probably not. You might die doing that, but I didn't, so I'm happy. And look at what we've got. Two heavies and two grenades. Can you say goodnight, Irene? Well, you're about to, because they're both dead. What a wonderful twist of fate. And now all we need to do is shoot that guy, so see you later. Shoot the two guys on the roof, and then shoot the turret guy, and you've done the sequence. And this spot is god tier. It's just, it's indicative of, like, if I'd have had that pistol on the spawn, 55 bullets, that's headshots galore if you take your time. You will never need to come out of cover, so at the beginning of the checkpoint, pick this gun up before you come this way, and you'll be able to do this effortlessly. Just pick your shots. You see what I mean? If you angle yourself correctly, you can shoot those people. It's just a little awkward and it looks goofy as shit. There's a grenade. That would have been handy to use that against him, but we didn't need to. And I think we're done. That's it. One of the hardest fights in the game, handled rather simply due to an incredible position and, you know, a big fuck you to the game. We put it on brutal and we brutalized them, which is what it's all about. Now, you get to pick up a bunch of stuff. You can reset the checkpoint here to put all the things back to where they were if you've picked up the resources and you want to re-pick them up. The next trigger is when you jump towards the mast that leads out of this area. And it's going to be a pretty awkward fight because it's a bunch of rocket launcher people who can kill you really quickly because it's on brutal. And what you want to do now is you want to pick up the magnum, the tau, whatever it's called, and you want to pick up the grenade launcher. The grenade launcher is on the roof of one of the boats. I think it's the one across from us. And if you can carry those two guns into this next sequence, you can trivialize the next fight. And then after that, doesn't matter what you carry in because you're going to be using a Rafika and you're going to be praying for death. Because it's one of the most frustrating parts of the game. But I managed to get through it quite quickly, so I was really happy for that. Because I've heard horror stories. I think Bic was there 2 hours, 3 hours of some fucking nightmare. Haddo was hating his life when he did that. And everybody else has had trouble on that spot. I was there for the first section, which I think is the one that everybody doesn't like, the first five dudes. I was only there for 5 minutes, so I was really, really fortunate with that. Later on, I got stuck a few more times on, you know, the bit where you jump and you push that guy off, on that bit there, because I kept getting shot on that. I was there for maybe 10 minutes, but for the most, I didn't suffer. And that's a good thing, because suffering can take a lot out of you mentally. I never got to the point where I was even remotely close to that, because once again, guys, if you've got a game that's harder, that just absolutely destroys you, then that is a good starting point for Brutal. Because if you can come to Brutal and look at this like a release, like an easier form of playing, then you're winning, because you'll never look at it the same. And it's such a powerful perspective to have. And I didn't think I'd have it, because Uncharted 2, I thought was really, really difficult. And then I came to this game, and I didn't think it was hard. And I went to the first game, and I didn't think it was hard either. Yeah, I know they're hard. It's just I was in a certain headspace where I could do them, and they didn't bother me. And it's all because I had a hard game kicking my dicking for so long. And if you have anything like that, guys, you're going to have way more success, because it's a fantastic motivator. Right now, the collision is not helping me, so it's making these shots way more difficult than they need to be. But you need to kill that guy who drops down quickly, because he will blow you up. He is the douchebag here, so make sure you get him. We have 118 bullets in this assault rifle, though, which is technically a submachine gun. If you could have 118 bullets in Uncharted 1, you would be laughing. Because on that game, ammunition's actually an interesting part of it. But it has this wonderful mechanic, which I'm looking forward to talking about on my Uncharted 1 guide. And they didn't carry it forward. In this game, melee combos are just not a thing. You can't do these fancy combos, I don't think, that give you extra ammo and give you special properties, which I think is a great mechanic that they lost. There's some cool stuff in that first game. I wish they'd carried it over. Have we got this guy? Gotta kill this fool. Oh, there he is. So use your cover. This bit's kind of frustrating because of the buoyancy of the boats. I appreciate that it's realistic, but is there anything more frustrating than not being able to aim? Like, aiming is tricky enough against robots with perfect aim, let alone when the boat's giving you seasickness. An absolute nightmare. But explore this area, restart the checkpoint if you need to get the Tau Magnum. It should be over on one of the boats. And get ready for the next sequence, because the next sequence is tough, guys. It's really tricky. Sweet. But it's only hard if you rush it and if you get unlucky. The worst part about the hanging section is there are times when you come out of cover to shoot and you get perfectly killed. Like, ba-boom, and you're done. You don't even see the second shot. It's so perfect. Those moments, there's nothing you can do, because it just happens. There are other moments when you're out of cover for an eternity returning fire, and they don't do that to you. And on those moments, it feels okay. But it's those other times where it feels like utter dog shit, where you're going to have the most issues. So I was a little conflicted here, because 120 Rafika shots is kind of a good deal, and I think I don't pick up the Magnum because of it, yeah. I don't know if that's a good choice. But I'm attached to whatever I get the most shots with, and the Rafika's a great gun. So feel free to use it. Oh, by the way, when you get across here, when you get to the part of this climbing where something falls apart, there's a dude that'll spawn and kill you, because if you don't know he's there, how would you react to this? It's too fast. But the moment it falls, that, aim over there and shoot him. Because he is really cheesy, and all of the games do this. They have these moments where you're climbing and somebody turns up, and on Brutal, it's ridiculous because you get murdered immediately. And I just don't think the developers understand difficulty in a lot of places. And my buddy Haddo said, on the first game, there's a horrible checkpoint on a truck where you can get killed before you even had a chance to do anything. He sent the developers a message, and they told him it was working as intended. What a bunch of dickheads. What a terrible thing to say. Like, I can't stand people who aren't willing to see the flaws in something they've made. That would be like me releasing a video that's got a problem in it, and you pointing out the problem in the video, and me telling you that, oh, I did that intentionally. Like, if the audio's desynced, that ain't intentional. If there's a part where there is no audio or my commentary's not on it, that's not intentional. These are problems that need to be fixed. And if I don't fix them, what the fuck am I doing? Like, that is a developer that's like, oh no, we made it that way. We made it that way. Did you know that certain game testers in companies get fired for being honest? For telling them problems with the game? And they fire them for it? It famously happened on Sonic 06. What a wonderful reward that is. You tell these people that their game is not ready, and they fire you. They actively cease employing you because you told them what they couldn't see because they're deluding themselves. What a load of shit. That's terrible. And for a developer to come out and say to somebody that that's working as intended is trash, because that section isn't working as intended because you can get killed before you've even had a chance to fight back. I'm sorry, that's not good design, and if you think that's good design, there is something wrong with your brain. Straight up. Like, I'll never understand why people will say that. That is an oversight on the dev's part, and I don't care who designed it, and I don't care what they think. I've beaten that section. Have you? Probably not. Like, how many people on that dev team do you think, outside of testing it to see what it was like, actually beat Brutal? I don't think many of them did. I think they gave that to the games testers because it's their job, and they suffered, and they got brutalized. I don't think the devs did that shit, because you can tell. You can tell when you get to a part where recovering from a cutscene gets you instantly murdered, and it's 100% coin tosses whether or not you live, has not been balanced, has not been designed. It's tweaking values that have repercussions further down the line that you never imagined. It's the moments you don't know are going to be difficult. Like at the end of Uncharted 1, where that bloody crate falls down and there's a quick time event, and after the quick time event, it leaves you in no man's land, waiting to be killed. And if you get to that piece of cover before those people spray you down, that's not up to you. That's not up to Bluepoint. That's up to the fucking game. It's nothing to do with skill, nothing to do with player ability. It's luck and bullshit, and there's nothing worse. This game has one section that's like that, and it's that tower run that I showed you on my fail video, where all you need to do is run forward and pray. But do you know why it's not bad in this game, other than being annoying? Because there's a checkpoint after it. That section on Uncharted 1, you have to do the final section of the game against the final boss on a checkpoint that you might not get back to if you get unlucky. It's horrible. It's terrible design. And people think that I take this perverse pleasure in shitting on games and complaining and whining. Like, I don't look at this kind of criticism as a whine. I see this as a critique. This is me airing a grievance that I believe is valid. Like, can you argue with me that this is not bad? And I can appreciate an amount of luck needed to do a sequence, but not in a sequence where they do not give you the tools to defend yourself. In this section coming up, is it difficult? Hell yes, but you can defend yourself. You can go into cover. You can govern when you come out of cover and when you fight back. It's down to your ability to shoot, which I'm going to discuss because you're going to see it right here. This is terrible, this bit. This is really miserable. So, three guys that all can murder you faster than you can murder them. And not only do they do animation cancels, where they look like they're going to reload, and then they immediately start attacking again, which is bullshit, but they sometimes will shoot forever and never reload. There doesn't seem to be any consistency with how many shots it takes them to reload. So the best strategy you can get into here is after they shoot, bob out and shoot. But you need to shoot once, and you need to be fast. because you do not have time to aim, you do not have time to get fancy, you just have to do the business. And you need to make sure people die before you get too aggressive. Never blind fire. Blind firing is worthless, it doesn't work. Whenever you see me blind fire, it's because I didn't get the input for the aiming because I didn't do it long enough. That's how quick I'm trying to do this, and the game won't let me do it. So, do you notice how my aimer, regardless of where I angle the camera, will always be below the enemies? Then I have to hold down to force that aimer to go up, because I play on inverted, I'm weird, to get the aimer on them. So not only are you fighting the delay it takes to aim, but then you're fighting the aiming itself because you can't keep your reticle on people because it resets where you've adjusted the camera. If you could adjust your camera without aiming like this, and then aim and have your gun be perfectly there, this guy it works a bit better on, so he's a little easier to hit because of the perspective. If you can do that, this would be easy, because you could essentially pre-aim and then pop out and shoot and be guaranteed to hit them, but the game resets it on certain parts and doesn't let you do it, so you have to make adjustments, and in those adjustments, you will die. And that's why this is trash, because it doesn't work properly. If they allowed you to use the camera to put your reticle, because you know where your reticle is, you've been playing this game for hours, you have an instinctual feel for where your reticle is. Move that camera, put that reticle on people and kill them, this would be fine. I'd have no issue. Like, he's perfect, it's this guy that's a problem. Because you notice how every time I come out of aiming, the camera adjusts. It adjusts back to being behind Drake and I can't put my camera on him. So I cannot get my aim to be on him when I come out of cover, so I have to adjust. And you see how far I have to move the camera to shoot him? That's a big distance on a game where you die this quick. So, it's just unforgiving. It's completely unforgivable, I think. And it's unfair. Because he doesn't have to adjust his camera, his aim is perfect. We do. And it's all because I have to go, what is that, 2 inches, 1 inch, from where the default reticle is to where he is. And in that space, there's an ocean of time where I can die. It's crap. It's really crap. And if you've never played this and you've never experienced it, you're probably listening to this being like, why is this dude so angry over something so silly? You have no idea how bad this part can be, because you've not played it. You need to experience what they've done here and see just how much it's against the player. It is 100% design dictating that you will die before you win. Like, this bit here is easy because we can put the camera on him. See that now? When I aim, it should be very close to him. Do you see how it was way close? Look at it. This is perfect. It's not changing where my reticle is as much. It's still defaulting it a little bit, but it's not like that other one. And I can kill him in a second and he's a piece of piss. No checkpoint though, boys. Kill this guy quickly or you will die. He's a dick. He's the guy that gets a lot of people if you don't know he's coming. No checkpoint, so keep moving. Get your ass up there. And then when you get to this other side, pick up some stuff. Jump across, and then no checkpoint. Stop looking, Chris. It's not happening. And that's how hungry you are for this to end, because it's not a fun section. But when you get here, there's a checkpoint. So as we jump across here, you're safe, and you're okay. And that's the hard bit done. Everything else at this point is nowhere near as bad as that first experience. So push him off, kill the two guys rappelling. And then there's going to be a guy immediately behind you, so spin around and murk him before he does any cheeky bullshits. I don't like spawns like this, where you think it's clear, and then boom, random skinhead behind you shoots you immediately. And then once he's dead, you're free to climb. But when you start climbing, you're going to trigger more people. And once again, we're going to come up against a moment where you have to be very quick or you're dead. And this guy, it's random where he pops up, but I tried to pre-fire him then, it didn't work. But you'll notice the camera default there was on him, so I didn't have to wrestle with the camera at all, so I was able to kill him really well. There's a guy above me right now, you see him? You want to be really careful, because he's one of those that sometimes he gets involved, sometimes he doesn't. And you can shoot him through the fence or through the floorboards, but it's kind of tricky to make it work. And in the time that you're doing that, he might shoot you twice and kill you. This is me being super Agent Squirrel right now. I'm all high-flying, high-intensity, special agent. There's no enemies to your left here. I'm just doing this because I'm not too sure of the spawns. But keep pushing forward. I'm saving the grenade launcher for a rainy day, and guess what? The game takes it off me, so don't do that, guys. Use the grenades. They're precious, but they're not that precious, and when you get to, I think it's rough seas, the game takes it off you anyway, so I was saving it for the hard bits, and I never even got to use it, which is really depressing. But this is tricky, because once again, the default aim here is at the middle of the screen, so you have to aim upwards to get these shots, and in doing that, you risk death. All considered though, guys, the keys to beating these sequences is to not get greedy, take your time, pick your shots, be as accurate as you can, and understand that when they're reloading, they can be vulnerable, but they can also fake you out with this bullshit move they've got. And fire after they fire, because they always give you an intermission in between, but you've got to be quick. You can't be slow, you can't mess around, you've got to know what you're doing. And I cannot give you gun skill in this game, I can't give you fast shooting and accuracy, because I don't have it sometimes, you know, and it's not something that I can just pass along. But you will get there. Try not to get mad, you know, distract yourself, do what you can. And when you're at the point like this, you're practically done. You can still die fast because it is brutal, but for a dude like this who's in massive vulnerable stages, just pop him once and then proceed to stunlock him. Because the good thing about people like that, which is different to the people above, is when you shoot once, they'll generally react in some way. In this game, not so much, so you can't guarantee it, but sometimes if you see it, you can punish it that way. If this was Uncharted 1, regardless of where you shoot them, they'd do a ridiculous, "Ooh, I just got shot," kind of thing, and then you can just proceed to just bang, 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 and like four shots and they're dead, one shot to the face. But once you get here, you've done the bit that's going to really test your patience, the bit that's really going to make you want to pull your hair out. And hopefully you'll have a run like I did, where you died a few times, you understood the bullshit, and then you just kind of got patient and got it. Unless, if that doesn't happen, you might be there a long time. You know, many people have been, so they will know your pain. But I think this is where they're going to take the grenade launchers off us, which is really sad. I've been saving it for a rainy day, and that day never came. It's the diluvian syndrome that I seem to have. I'm waiting for a flood. A flood that never comes. So, after you come off the zipline, this guy's going to chuck you down here, and you're going to be faced with a couple of dudes to shoot. I don't get this particular section. There's a handful of people, but if you've just done that hanging section, this is going to feel like the easiest section in the world, because there's only one person here who's dangerous, which is him. And the dudes with the lasers couldn't kill you if you paid their parents to give them like a scholarship in killing you in this sequence. Because there's something about the sniper guys with the lasers. It takes them 20 minutes to fire, and it's incredibly fair, but I don't understand it. I've played games where the moment that red dot lines up, you're dead. And if you come from a game like that to a game like this, you're going to see those people as candy, because they're free. They're so free. And in Uncharted 1, it does this wonderful thing where the people with the Desert Eagles, they are like those guys, they're idiots. They'll aim at you for a week before they shoot you. And then you get to that weird place outside of the monastery and the church, and the snipers are really quick. And you're not used to it because you're used to those silly buggers with the Desert Eagles, which I thought was hilarious. But keep on pushing forward. We're coming to the end of the chapter, guys. And if you can beat this, you can beat this entire game on Brutal. Because this is the only part where I think you're going to have the worst time. There's a couple of really tricky parts coming up, but I've got great strategies, and I have full faith that you're going to nail it, guys. You really are. Here comes a heavy. Save your ammunition. Just beat him up. It's the best way to deal with them when they're on their own. There's this weird part about heavies in this game where being closer to them is the safest place you can be, because they will not shoot you. You know, you have to be a decent distance for this dude to use his shotgun. He's too proud. And it's really empowering. Uncharted 1 doesn't have that. Uncharted 1, he'd fucking shoot you from where he stood now. It's ridiculous. They drive by you when they run around corners. It's really, really brutal. But all in good time. So you can pick up his shotgun if you need to. But this is the end of the video, guys. Thank you for watching. And you take care now.